Recording's over.
Oh, how lovely. Aren't you all just the sweetest?
Ah, yes. The people of Wunderhorn. At last they come to show their admiration.
More talking animals. Aw, you are so cute.
Good gracious. The girl wastes no time in forgoing talent for superficiality. Me, the great Rustvik van Betoriki. My word, truly there's no respect for the greats anymore.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm sorry, Mr. Rustvik. I didn't mean any offense.
All right, all right. Very well. What is it you want, then?
All right. I better let you all get back to what you're doing. Excuse me.
Greetings again, Kamina. What is it you interrupt the great Van Betoriki with now?
Why are you the great Van Betoriki? Are you famous?
Ah, am I? My word. Were you educated in the slightest, Kamina? Oh, the people of Bremen. They did love me so. It is true. Alas, all good things must come to an end.
They stopped coming to your shows?
No. I was exiled, forced to abandon my town like a mere common criminal. But I persevere, as all greats do. Do not fear or mourn for me, Kamina.
Right. I'll try not to. But what did you do? Did you do something bad, Rustvik?
Well, my companions and I had procured a residency in the cottage for our retiring comfort. However, some Bremen commoners took it upon themselves to call it, squatting.
So you're all homeless, then? Do you have anywhere to stay?
The proverbial cat is out of the bag. Might as well profess it all. If truth be told, we had reserved a desirable lakeside residence. It was perfect. Alas, upon our arrival, a band of uncouth rogues took it upon themselves to, bargain with the owners.
Oh, you mean they struck a better deal and the owners ran with it?
Ah, well, you could say that. The owners did indeed run. Far, far away.
Oh, that kind of bargaining. Oh my, well, that's not fair, Rustvik. That's robbery.
Dear Fräulein, they're not called rogues without reason.
But someone should do something. Rustvik, that cabin should have been yours. Just leave it with me. I'm going to go see if I can level with them and get you guys your home.
Level? Level with uncouth rogues? You do that.
Where was the cabin you guys wanted to settle down in?
If truth be told, we had reserved a desirable lakeside residence. It was perfect. Alas, upon our arrival, a band of uncouth rogues took it upon them.
Just leave it with me.
Level?
Don't these guys talk too? I've never met animals before who talk. Is that a Wunderhorn kind of thing or something?
It is an education thing, and I don't want to be considered a common animal thing. But sadly, no. My companions are without the same expertise of the human language. I'm afraid you'll have to restrict your swooning to me.
All right. I better let you all get back to what you're doing. I best get looking for these objects, then. Yes. Okay. I'll see you soon, then, with the objects. Okay, then. again, sir.
Evening again, little miss. You found that wizard friend of yours?
I did. He, well, she was in the alley after all, so thank you.
Aye.
Well, now you see, now I need to find a lake behind the mill somewhere.
Mill is straight behind this here tavern. And then past that is them there woods.
Okay then, thanks once again. Sorry?
He says to hold on, little miss. Not so hasty.
Really? All of that? Do you really hear what he's saying? Because to me...
Aye, those there woods, protected by old magic they are. Folks going out there, they need themselves a good guide, see? The blacksmith, he's one, but he's been away a whiles now. And then there's this fellow Gil, wetting his lips here.
Oh, I see. Then, hello there, sir.
Working hours are up for Gil today, though. And now he's started at the bar. Well, so long as there's beer for him, he ain't going nowheres.
But this is a tavern. He must have a lifetime of beer.
Aye.
Good at this. All that practice is really paying off now. It looks like I believe the lever there should pump out whatever's in those pipes if I use it. I'm sorry, Mr. Bartender, but desperate times call for desperate measures. Just quickly put these back the way they were.
I don't know how to break this to you, Gil, so I'm just gonna say it. There's no more beer left.
Yay! No more beer! Guess we'll just have to get going to the lake now, huh?
Alright, listen carefully. Only saying this once. Lake, straight down that way. Murderous thieves live that way to the north. But don't go there. They're murderous. Hence, murderous thieves. Back the way we came to get back to the village. Questions?
Well, just to be sure, I...
Good. No questions, then. Bye.
In case I forget how to get back, never mind. Guess I'll figure it out. Hopefully. Excuse me, sir?
Oh. Hello there. You shouldn't be out here, you know. This is a dangerous place.
So everyone keeps telling me. Are you okay? Why are you out here all alone and sad, mister?
I'm hunting the beast that's terrorizing the village. Can't you tell?
This seems like a pretty nice place with nice things. Are you sure it's around here?
Of course I'm sure. I'm a master huntsman, don't you know? I know these woods like the back of my hand. I'm tracking his... trail, his scent and such, or something.
Okay, if you say so, mister. Can you tell me more about this beast? I don't know if I can, but maybe I can help somehow?
Oh, that's very sweet of you, kid. But no, this is much too dangerous for you.
But maybe if you just tell me...
No means no, kid. You're just like her, you know? You're just like my own girl. You kids are a stubborn lot.
Well, best let you get back to, whatever it is you're doing.
Oh, yes. Focusing my, traditional tracking technique. Or something.
How peculiar that the girl would have this place revisited. It has taken some years, but things are now becoming quite entertaining. Oh, hello there, young one.
Hello, mister.
Say, you don't suppose you could help an old man, could you?
Oh, well, sure. What can I help you with?
Oh, you really are quite unlike her. Never mind, that will do. I must be off for now. I sense the dragon's guard won't be down much longer, you see. Till next time, Anna.
What? What was that all about? And how did he know my name? Hello? Weissefrauen? Is that you?
So young.
Oh, hi. I don't mean to bother you. I'm looking for, something.
Come closer. So young. So hungry. Closer.
No, I'm okay where I am, thanks. Oh, dear. Hi.
Join us. It will all be yours, darling. Young. So young. So much life.
No! Stop! Please stop!
What? Who's there?
I'm sorry, I don't mean to scare you or anything.
No, don't be sorry. Hans, you saved me. Thank you.
Oh, I'm no hero, really. These cursed creatures. I fell prey to them, but they won't take any more life as long as I'm here.
Oh, no. You could say I'm a little used to ghosts now. You guys are harmless.
Yes, exactly. Oh, it's so nice to finally meet someone who doesn't run into the woods screaming.
Anna, nice to meet you.
Thank you, Anna. Thank you for not running away.
Some ghosts I met before, they were kind of trapped. Is that the same for you too?
I can't seem to leave the lake, but I don't mind. There's something I don't want to leave here.
You mean the amber orb?
Not exactly. No, it's a friend, I think. someone who meant a lot to me. All I know is that I meant to help them, and I can't leave until I finish what I started.
That's so sweet, Hans. If you can remember them, who knows? Maybe I can help? Do you mind me asking how you,
It's all right, Anna. You can say it. How I became a ghost? It was so long ago. As days upon days upon days go by, I realize that I start to forget.
Oh, is there much you do still remember?
Yes, I remember the amber orb. I came here looking for it. I knew it would be dangerous, I knew. But I desperately needed to find it anyway.
The amber orb. That's what I've come for, too.
The Vice of Frauen treasure it. They need it. They'll never part with
it.
It lures people here just like you and me. And they come. The treasure hunters, witches, lots of them. They have all failed. They either run away or go into the water forever.
If I don't get the orb, though, Hans, my grandpa, he'll... I don't know why, but someone cursed him, and I have to get the orb to make a cure.
You're very brave, Anna, and so kind to come to a place like this. Wait, I remember now. I came here for someone, too. I don't know who anymore. But I know that yearning, I feel it. The need to help someone, no matter how high the cost.
Is there really nothing I can do?
This might be a long shot, but the Vice of Frauen, there's something that changes them.
Yes, anything. Whatever it is, I'll try.
They sing a lot. They're different around music. And once, not so long ago, a band of musicians traveled through. I remember. The Vice of Frauen, they were stunned. So silent and reverent.
Music? Well, I can sing. I could sing for them?
No, not music of that sort. Others have whistled, hummed, and sung in these parts, and it's not been the same. It was something specific, something wooden, with strings. I see it, but I don't recall its name anymore. I'm sorry, Anna.
Hans, you've been so helpful. You have nothing to be sorry for. It was really nice to see you, but I should get going now.
Of course. And nice to see you too, Anna. You know where to find me if you need me again.
All right. Thieves or not, it's time someone talked to this bunch.
Who's that? Oh no, it's not the boy ghost, is it?
Jeez, will you listen to yous two? Bunch of no good.
See, just a measly little brat.
Hey, I'm not a brat. I don't think.
What do you want, huh? What you doing out here?
Okay, now, my grandpa always told me that stealing is...
Wait. Your grandpa? What is this? You even know where you are right now, huh? Do you?
House that you and your friends have, occupied, and...
I'm stopping you there, yeah? You best turn back. Turn back, little girl. This is a murderer's house you're trying to enter here. I'm warning you now. You turn and walk away, and that will be the last of it. Now beat it!
Humph. How rude. They think they can just bully everyone to get their own way. Scare them away all the time. Well, not if I can help it. I think two can play at that game.
Did I tell you guys the one about the witch boy who drowned in the lake?
It's only all you ever talk about.
Oh, I don't like that one. Scary.
That's the point, you doofus. The silly ghost stories to scare you.
It ain't no silly story, though. It is the truth. It really happened.
Are you afraid of no ghosts?
Right near, here somewhere. And that lake, all filled with those things. He went in alive and happy boy, but then he'd come out a white and glowing ghost. His bright ghostly eyes roaming these here trees, weaving through, looking for revenge he is. That's not true. It's not true, is it?
The boy drowned all right, but there ain't no glowing white-eyed ghost here. Now shut your yaps before I shut him for you, you hear?
Just saying. When you least expect, like, maybe he'll... No!
Shut it, now, the two of you!
Right, boss.
If something was hard to find, Grandpa always said, "Oh, Anna, you may as well try and find a needle in a haystack. Wouldn't it be funny if I actually..." Oh, hold on. Well, there you go. Not so hard to find them after all, Grandpa. Hello.
Oh, goody. A little girl. Did you not read the sign? No, of course you didn't.
Look at that music box.
That's not just a music box. That's an heirloom of the great Viennese dancer.
Look at that puppy. Oh, that's so cute.
Really, is it any wonder I don't like kids in here? That, my dear child, is the exquisite craftsmanship of the late Madame...
Look at that monkey! He's playing cymbals! Oh my gosh! So cute! Your store has so many cute things, mister!
Yes, whatever you say. You don't seem to be leaving, so... Go ahead, look around. Then be off with you! You can't afford anything anyway!
What can I get with this?
That's... Gah! Where did you... a shiny rock.
No, silly. It's a diamond. These are meant to be worth a bit, aren't they?
Oh, yes. How silly of me. I'm not so sure they're worth that much, really.
Enough for that pretty violin, maybe?
Ha! Good grief, no. No, I think this is more in the range of... That lantern, over there on the ground. That's about all this can buy.
Oh, that's it? Nothing else? At all?
Take it or leave it, my final offer.
Well, I guess it is more useful than a little stone. All right, it's a deal. Hey, wait a second. This is broken.
It's an antique, you little brat. What do you expect? Nothing lasts forever.
Oh, yeah. I guess that's fair enough. Thank you for the trade, mister.
Just get out of here.
That sheet looks pretty old. I think it's been left hanging there for quite a while. And, well, it did get rather cold on that long trip here. I could use a sheet going home. Oopsie-daisy. Guess I still need a little more practice with this. I hope you don't mind me asking, but is your father the one who disappeared?
You know where my papa is?
I do. I found him.
Where? Where is he? Please tell me.
He's in the woods still.
But he's okay, isn't he? He's not hurt, right?
No, he's fine. He's perfectly okay.
Oh, thank goodness. Oh, that's such a relief. Thank you.
I'm Anna, and I'm glad I could help.
You really did. I was sure he was lost for good this time. Silly, silly Papa.
Silly
name's
Papa.
Ashley, by the way. Pleased to meet ya.
Lost? But he's a master huntsman. I thought he knew the woods like the back of his hand.
He likes to stretch the truth just a little. Don't tell anyone this, especially not my Papa, but he's not really a master hunter at all. It's that silly beast. The one that's been stealing all the food. He can't let it go. He won't. He promised everyone in the village he would help them. As long as that beast remains in the woods, so will Papa.
Can you tell me more about this beast? It's stealing food?
Yep, the village's fruit. We're a fruitless village.
That doesn't sound very beast-like at all.
But it's eating all of it. The vendor who usually collects the fruit, he's terrified of it. A ferocious wild creature, he says. Gnashing teeth and long, razor-sharp claws.
Oh my, that does sound rather beastly.
Uh-huh, and that's what my poor papa is out there trying to find.
I was wondering, this lantern... Is there any way you can make it work again?
Oh, you kidding me? Piece of cake! Only, without Papa here, I'm kinda crazy busy right now.
How does your father normally find his way out of the woods, then?
Usually I just get Gil from the tavern to help me find him. Then I just growl and make noises so he chases me and I lead him back here.
But Ashley... He's hunting the beast.
Well, good thing he's a terrible huntsman. Anyway, he caught on to me. He figured it out, so now I guess it's the beast or nothing.
I'll let you get back to work, Ashley.
Be careful out there, okay? If that beast is out there...
There's nothing back.
Evening once again, dear girl. And to what do I owe this pleasure?
This beast of the woods the villagers speak of. This fruit-stealing beast. It's you, isn't it, Reynard?
And what, pray tell, brings you to such a conclusion?
Well, you... like a beast. I mean, the descriptions are completely wrong, really.
Hey!
You haven't got any razor claws or teeth, and you're quite cute and small and fluffy.
All right. Yes, yes, enough. It's true. I lack beastly qualities. But you are quite right. The beast is the title I have been given, and one I must abide by.
So you like being a beast, then? But they're scared of you, Reynard. Terrified.
Precisely. Adapt to survive. And adapt I have. Once I thought to find assistance in picking fruit, cautiously leading villagers through the woods. But then they take all and share none. What option do I have but to adapt once again?
But they say that you've been taking all the fruit, Reynard. That's not fair.
My dear, men have a predictable tendency to exaggerate.
Oh, I see. I'm sorry for judging, Reynard. You really are a very clever little guy, you know that?
You flatter, my dear. But you and I, we are not so very different in that regard.
I should probably get going now.
Very well, my dear. I'll be seeing you soon enough, I'm sure.
Strange thing to say. I wonder what makes him so sure of that.
Anna, what's up?
I was wondering, this lantern, is there any way you can make it work again?
Oh, you kidding me? Piece of cake. Ah, only without Papa here, I'm kind of crazy busy right now.
You get back.
Be careful out there.
Evening once again, dear girl. And to what do I owe this pleasure?
Reynard, I think I know a way you can help me. You said before that you could lead villagers to the fruit, right? And the blacksmith, well, he needs to be led home, right?
I'm not sure I'm particularly comfortable with the direction this is going.
Oh, please, Reynard. That poor blacksmith. He's only trying to help the village.
My dear, I appreciate your sentiments, but you're asking me to give up my orchestrated food supply.
Well, you can come back to my farm. We have plenty of food to share there, but, well, you know, if you think there's someone else who's clever enough to escape one little huntsman, then...
All right, I concede you win. I care not for acquiescing on terms of pride, but I respect your tactics.
Oh, thank you, Reynard. I really appreciate it.
Of course, my dear. And with that, I suppose I might as well be off.
See you. He's back, Anna. My papa has finally returned, safe and sound.
How about that? That's great news, Ashley.
We're already right back on track with work, if there's anything you need.
I was wondering, this lantern, is there any way you can make it work again?
Haha, oh, you kidding me? Piece of cake. One second. And done.
Oh, wow. That really was quick. Thank you so much. get back to work, Ashley. Oh, and make a kind of fake ghost costume thing. Only this sheet is wrecked. I could do something like that if the sheet was fixed. Oh, yes. This would make for great sewing thread. Days of practicing my sewing really paid off. Oh, that would make a nice ghost-looking thing, only the sheet is missing something. Oh, and make a kind of fake ghost costume thing. The themes were talking about ghost stories. That might not be a bad idea. Still missing something, though. There were some more details the thieves mentioned. I should go listen again. Ah, yes. A ghost with glowing eyes, like in the thieves' story. That's pretty convincing, really. Would sure scare me if I saw it floating around the woods. Give these guys a taste of their own medicine. Ooh.
Did you hear that?
Hear what?
Ooh.
You're dead.
Oh, I feel good. You don't think.
First you lot are shaking and slamming over a little kid, and now some wind useless. Really, the ball can do.
There's nothing here but.
What is it? It's dead.
Excuse me.
Greetings again, Kamina. What is it you interrupt the great Van Betoriki with now?
Rustwick, I did it! I found a place for all of you to stay.
By Jove! You don't mean it!
I do mean it. Come on, I'll show you. So, what do you guys think?
Quaint. Quiet. Tranquil, even. It is no Schloss Sanssouci, but perhaps I shall lower my expectations in this instance.
Yes, perhaps.
Very well. You have helped the great Rustwick van Betoriki to retire in peace. For that, you have my sincerest gratitude. Thank you, my dear.
You are most welcome, Rustwick. I'm glad I could help.
Now, if you'll excuse me...
Aren't happy endings so nice?
Oh, it's you. Again?
Sorry to bother you, Rustwick. I was just wondering, do you think you could help me with one last performance? The Vice of Fallen.
Kamina, you must understand. Retired means retired. Finished. The end.
I know, I understand. Really, I do. It's just... Well, my Grandpa's sick and...
Please, please, spare me your tales of woe. I've heard it all.
Mr. Roostwig, I did help you, remember? It would mean so much to me.
Very well. Here. I have no more use of it. If you so desperately need to hear the violin, well, I suggest you get practicing.
Oh, well, I could give it a shot, I guess.
Now, if you'll excuse me.
Well, I guess that's something, right?
Hold it. Just get out of here.
Okay, let's see here.
Such beauty. We must reward.
Oh, yes. Yes. Perhaps the amber ore as a reward?
Yes. Our treasure. Our most beloved possession. Guard. We must guard, but we must reward. The amber ore. Yes. We will get the reward.
Anna, you did it! That was amazing!
Ah, shucks. Well, to be completely honest, I kind of cheated.
Never mind that. You broke their hold over the Amber Orb after all these years. It's unbelievable.
Well, I couldn't have done it without your help, Hans. If there's anything I can do for you, something to help your spirit rest.
It's strange, but I feel like you're already helping me. No, not me. It's actually an old friend.
Oh, is that so? Well, that's good then, I think.
It is. I feel at peace now. The reason I came here to this lake. It's so long ago, though. I just remember her reaching to me. She's so sad. It was me. I made her sad. Anna, it was a mistake. Such a terrible mistake. I should never have come here.
Hans.
But what you're doing, I can't explain it, but it's helping my friend. I know it is.
Then let's get this spell done. For Grandpa, and for her.
Thank you for everything, Anna. Thank you.
Goodbye, Hans. I hope you're at peace now, wherever you are.
sir?
Oh dear.
Have you or have you not seen either of these two?
No. No. I have seen no such, deviants.
Deviants indeed, sir. Of the highest order. Well, second highest.
Who, might a gentleman who's not at all involved, inquire as to what they have done?
I cannot say, good citizen, but the order comes direct from the queen herself. Well, queen to be. Bob, what have I told you about this? Once again, we're in the middle of an interrogation, and yet it's all about Bob, isn't it? Well? Yes, you're right. It's not always about Bob. I'm sorry, sir. It's quite all right, Bob. It's been a hard run today. What say we put our tensions aside and sample some of this fine establishment's offerings? What say you, good citizen? You will join us, won't you?
But, sirs, I'm not allowed to go in there.
Nonsense! A man with a fine mustache is yours? Ha! What pish-posh!
Well,
now, it's in order.
And just like that, the Weissefrauen went down and brought the orb up to me personally.
Thrilling. You have the orb anyway, that's all that matters.
Well, yes, but you know that's quite a story, isn't it?
Yes, nothing beats a child prattling on while people lay cursed and waiting.
Oh, yes. Yes, I'm sorry.
That is but one item, child. Don't get too excited. There's still a ways to go.
I best get looking for these objects, then. Yes. Okay. I'll see you soon, then, with the objects. Okay, then.
Let's hang out. And we'll continue this other time. Let's pull you up.